大家好，我是清华大学电机系黄远介。Today we'll be talking about electromagnetic power and energy, and the focus is on the power of the electromagnetic wave. And the first topic, I'm going to mention the important physical quality. We call it a pointing vector. This is going to give you the direction and also intensity of an electromagnetic radiation. And we talked about phase velocity before, but when we discuss the energy propagation, we have to bring out the concept of group velocity. And the third topic is about dispersion. And this is related to the propagation of the electromagnetic energy at different frequency. And to simplify the discussion, I will show you how dispersion can be discussed on a diagram called dispersion diagram. And finally, we'll review a few key concepts. So the first topic is pointing vector. And I first show you this general scenario for transmission and also the receiving of the electromagnetic radiation. Consider that you have some antenna, transmitting antenna, somewhere either on the ground or in the air. And you put the receiving antenna somewhere far away. And if you want to receive the electromagnetic wave, apparently you need to know the intensity of this radiation. At the same time, you need to know the direction of this radiation as well. For example, if you put this receiving antenna somewhere down below, then you might not be able to detect much signal. So we have to model the problem relevant to this electric field and magnetic field, but we need to consider both intensity and also direction of the radiation. I want to start the discussion by showing you this vector identity. And if you do divergence of A cross B, the two vectors in space, then you can separate this calculation into two parts. And this is a little bit similar to differentiation by parts. But be careful that there's a minus sign here, because when you do the cross product or doing the curl operation, the order of the calculation matters. And then I want to show you the Faraday's law. Curl of E equal to minus of the partial derivative of magnetic field with respect to time. If you put this into this expression, just replace curl of A with curl of E. And also, the if you replace this the curl of B with the curl of H, and this is the Ampere's law, then you can organize this mathematical expression into this the somewhat complicated form. And we can further simplify this expression. But I want you to pay attention to the first term here, which is divergence of E cross H, because later on, this is going to tell you the direction of the radiation and also intensity of the radiation. Now, let's try to simplify this expression by recalling the proportionality between B field and H field, D field and E field in a simple linear medium. We also know that in the ohmic material, the current is directly proportional to the electric field. So let's put these three simple relationships into this expression and group the terms. Then you end up having divergence of E cross H is equal to three terms right here. The first term is related to the magnetic field. The second term is related to the electric field. And then the third term is related to the ohmic laws in the material. So let's just separate our discussion into these three terms. And the first term is something you are familiar with already, because one half of mu H squared is the magnetic energy density we talk about in lecture 16.3, electromagnetic one. And the second term is also something you learned about before. This is the energy density for the electric field. And I show you this in lecture 8.3, electromagnetic 1. And then finally, this term, sigma E squared, sigma is the conductivity, which is related to the ohmic power loss per unit volume in a piece of conductor. And this is derived from the Joule's law in lecture 11 of the electromagnetic 1. So now, we more or less understand the physical meaning of each term. And think about that, you try to apply divergence theorem to this expression. Imagine that you have a space and then there's a volume, and then you do an integration over the volume. So you can apply divergence theorem to this volume integration of this divergence of E cross H, and convert it into a surface integration. And on the right-hand side, you still keep the volume integration for these three terms. So on the right-hand side, you can see that the energy density is integrated over the volume. So now you have the total energy inside. And don't forget that you have a partial derivative of this energy over time. So effectively, you are calculating the power change inside a volume. So the first term is the temporal change of the stored electric and magnetic energy. And this change of the energy is within a volume like this. And this part is related to the ohmic loss inside the volume. So think about that you have a volume, and then you know the change of energy inside. So what is left is going to be the radiation going out from the volume based on energy conservation. Because on the right-hand side is the change of the energy inside this volume. And the uncompensated part is going to be equal to the radiation power going away from this volume. So this term E cross H integrate over the surface is very important, because physically it means that you have radiation going out from this volume. So if you just integrate over the this enclosed surface, then you can calculate the total power from this volume. And sometimes, for example, this volume could be a piece of antenna. So now we have a quite important expression, which is E cross H, and we call this pointing vector. And the unit of this the pointing vector is watt per square meter in the MKSA unit system. And this unit is the same as the intensity of light or intensity of radiation. And important thing is that this is a vector, so it also tells you the direction of power propagation. For example, if we have a harmonic wave like this, electric field is expressed by an amplitude multiplying with a cosine omega t minus kz plus phi e, some arbitrary phase, and this wave propagates along z direction. And we set it to polarize along x direction. The corresponding magnetic field is expressed by this, and the phase could be different from the phase for the electric field. And from the TEM wave propagating along z direction, we know that this magnetic field is going to polarize along y direction. Now let's apply this expression to the multiplication of these two terms. So you get an instantaneous pointing vector like this. Basically, you just multiply these two together. But be careful that this is the vector cross product. So you have to calculate the cross product of AX and AY, and you get AZ. So this means that this power is propagating along Z direction. So it's very nice that the pointing vector will tell you the intensity of the radiation. At the same time, it also tells you the direction of the power flow. And in this multiplication, you can see that this pointing vector is a function of position and time. Now, in most cases, we are interested in the average power flow. So let's continue to do this calculation by using some trigonometry rules. So this multiplication can be separated into two terms, adding together. The first term has 2 omega t minus 2 kz plus some arbitrary phase. And this term is a function of time, oscillating between minus 1 and plus 1. This means that the power will be generated at a certain time, but the power will also be taken back in the next half cycle. So on average, this term will go to zero if you integrate it over a long time. But this term is not a function of time. It's not a function of distance. And this is the stationary value. So this term gives you the average power for this electromagnetic wave. And this is how we really care, because this is the power going away. We cannot take it back. We can only try to collect it somewhere else. So overall, if you want to know the average power of electromagnetic radiation, you care about this term. And so based on this calculation, if you average over, say, one period of this oscillation, then you end up having this average power propagating along z direction. And this is directly related to the resource, and you should really care about it. But every time, if we do the calculation for the average power, starting from these two expressions, and then try to do this trigonometry, the algebra, it's a little bit tedious. So we compare this result with the more straightforward calculation. So on this page, let's first turn this cosine function into the phasor notation. So you only keep the spatial part and also the phase, but you drop the omega t from this expression. You do the same thing to this magnetic field. So you have this phasor for the magnetic field. And if you try to multiply these two terms together, which is the phasor of E and also complex conjugate of H, then you end up having an expression exactly the same as the calculation from the average power. So in the future, in fact, you can just start from the phasor notation and do the calculation, and then quickly you can end up having an expression for the average power. But I just say that for electromagnetic radiation, the propagation direction of the energy is going to be also important. So let's try to preserve the directions. And we define a complex pointing vector right here, which is the one half of the phase of E crossed with the complex conjugate of the phase of H. And this complex pointing factor will simplify your calculation for the average power, because if you do this calculation, you will end up having a simple way to derive this average power by taking the real product of it. But at the same time, this expression also tells you the direction of the electromagnetic propagation. Because this is a vector, and this is also a vector, the cross product will tell you the direction of the power flow. So in this session, we have a few key points, and I want to share with you in Mandarin. 在这一个章节里头呢，我们介绍了什么叫做 pointing vector。 这个 pointing vector 呢，在数学上头表示成这个电场的向量。 跟磁场向量的 cross product， 这个 cross product 呢，不只是告诉你这个量有多强，那同时呢，它的方向也告诉你。那这个的这个单位呢是这个 intensity 的单位，所以它告诉你这个辐射的强度有多大，同时呢也包含了这个它的这个传输的方向。但是呢，我们经常在 计算的时候，我们在乎的是平均功率、平均强度，因为随时间变化的另外一项呢是变化在正负一这个值里头，所以平均之后会消失掉。所以呢，在计算平均功率的时候呢，如果说我们从这个complex pointing vector 开始计算的话，会特别的快速。那这个 complex pointing vector 的定义呢，是你把这个 harmonic field 的电场跟磁场把它写出来，然后做一个计算。这个计算呢是把这个 E cross H 的 complex conjugate 然后除以2。那你如果要得到这个平均的这个强度的时候呢，你只要取它的实数部分，你就得到一个平均的强度的这个解。所以这是这个单元这个小节里头几个重点。